Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of How's It Burn? My name is Jen and I'm the artist behind North Star Pyrography. Today I'm going to show you how leather burns. Leather can be used for a variety of things, such as clothing and even furniture coverings, wall hangings, purses, accessories, anything like that. You can get some very beautiful detail on it as well, depending on the type of leather that you're using. This here is just some like suede leather that I had picked up from a saddle shop. And it's a really great place to get some leather. All right, so let's get started. All right, so here we have some leather and there's a few different types that I use. These are the ones that I mainly use when I burn on leather. This one here is some vegetable tan leather. I get this pre-made in bracelets from Tandy Leather and they're really great. They're a little stiff, but you can work them to loosen them up a bit. You can also dye these, color them, put clear coats on them. And then these two here, I got these from my local saddle shop. They were just some scraps that he had. And they are dyed, they're not heavily dyed. I do recommend trying to stay away from the more heavily dyed leathers and anything that has that looks shiny because it's got like a finish on it or something, like a clear coat, anything like that, a protectant. And they just put off really toxic fumes. These are the ones I use the most. This one has a little bit higher piling than this, and so the burn can be completely different. So I have my pen tip that I've made here, mainly use it for outlining and stuff like that. I have it on a fairly high heat. It's relatively easy to burn on this. The other stuff, because the piling is a little bit higher, it can be a little bit more difficult. You can get some really great shading, and because you don't clear coat these, they're not gonna fade. The shading's not gonna fade from a coating. It might fade over time because like any other wood burning, it will fade as it ages. It'll fade in UV light, anything like that. So here I've got my ballpoint on for stippling. I'm just doing this quick because my pen's still turned up high. I don't want to burn a hole right through. You can stipple. If they get too close, they just kind of start to blend in with each other. Here I've got my spear shader, and I use this for outlining. And you can get some great lines on here. Nice and smooth, very sharp, which is really great when you're doing designs on here. You can get some detail in the leather as well, like fur and stuff like that. This is a really great one to burn on. I've burned buffalo on this, mountains on it, and they're really great because you can frame them, mat them and frame them. They're easy for shipping. Here we have the vegetable tan leather. This burns quite easily. It's very unforgiving though. I have thrown out quite a few of these just from making mistakes. I use a pencil and you can lightly trace your design on, which is helpful. So here again, I'm just using the spear shader. That's a little better. You can get the really nice clean lines. I like using this one for outlining on the leather because again, it gives it those nice crisp edges. And I love the texture, like the way you can feel it on the leather. I love that. And you can shade as well. So to give an example of how easy this vegetable tan leather can burn, my pen is on a 2. Not even. It's just below the 2 and it can shade really dark. So it might depend on the tip you're using for shading. So here I'm just using my flat round shader. And you can get a relatively smooth shade. If you're really careful, you can get some detail in it. And then this is just my ballpoint for stippling. I have it turned up to about a 5. It does melt through fairly well. And the stippling on here looks really neat and it gives it a really fun texture, like to even feel it. It feels neat. And the vegetable tan, it does really well. You can get a little bit of
cracking in it. You can kind of see, let's see if I can see there. That's just from the stiffness of the burn. I do find loosening these up before you burn on them helps quite a bit from doing that. But you can get some really cool stuff on here. Like I said, painting on them with the burn is a lot of fun. So this is the one we just did. And then I did this one before on this other darker piece. And it's almost got like a reddish color to it when burned on. And the burn did cause it to ripple quite a bit. And they're a lot of fun. It's something different to try. And I love working with others.